Okay, let's, oh, there we go. Let's try this again. I want to welcome all of you after a one-year hiatus back to our auditorium for our annual Christmas concert. I know the kids are excited to perform. We all are. We've been working hard. I have a few announcements before we start. First announcement I have is technology, cell phones. If you've got these, can you please silence them or turn them off during the concert so they don't go off? That would be nice. We'll end up getting the wrong pitch otherwise. You will see me on my cell phone because COVID did one thing. It gave us a little technology. I learned how to run the lights from here. It was great until the last light cue and my phone froze last time. So if it's dark for a while, you know I'm trying to get my phone back online. Next thing is, we ask that you hold all applause until the very final chimes. We want the concert to be a continuous type of concert, a continuous show. And so please hold all applause until the very, very end of the concert. And because the choirs, if you've never been here, the choirs will be moving back and forth and up and down at times. We ask that you remain seated during the concert because the kids are under strict orders that nobody gets in their way or pick them up and bring them up on stage. So unless you know the music, you could be in trouble. You could be standing up there. We'll hand you music. We'll find it. We'll make it work. So, but we are very happy to see all of you here tonight and we can gather again to do this and to celebrate the season. And so we hope you enjoy the show. And thank you very much for coming.
Christmas, a promise made to us before our world was formed. Christmas, a promise of love and hope given to us.
To be, he is Alpha and Omega.
traditions and celebrations may be different, the excitement is the same around the world. Christmas is a time to hope for peace on earth and goodwill to all.
Thank you.
The sights and sounds of the season truly do make this the most wonderful time of the year.
Thank you.
Christmas isn't without its stresses. As we all learned in National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation, a gathering of family and friends isn't without some turmoil. Is there anything more magical than the first snowfall? You don't hear it, you simply see it and feel it. And when it is over, everything looks clean and white. In our part of the world, snow is something that most enjoy and look forward to. It is like a magic wand that makes everything softer and beautiful. Christmas carols had many different countries of origin, but they all hearken to the joy of the season and the events that happened during that time.
Dr. Seuss's
how the Grinch stole Christmas, even the Grinch learned that no matter how much you try and avoid it, the spirit of Christmas, it will find you. For after all, Christmas doesn't come from a store. Christmas means so much more. And Christmas will always be as long as we have we. Many stories have been written about heroes who have saved Christmas. None is more famous than a poor little picked-on reindeer. But here's another version of that story with a modern rock and roll twist.
Thank you.
Christmas tree, but the entire house, inside and out, adds to the festive feeling that's in the air at this time of year. And many believe that the more decorations you put up, the better. They live by the saying, go big or go home.
Oh, by golly, have a holly, jolly Christmas.
The author, Shirley Sally, in reference to Christmas, says, "Christmas now surrounds us. Happiness is everywhere. Our hands are busy with many tasks as carols fill the air. The closer we get to Christmas, the more excitement there is everywhere as old traditions are kept and new ones are planned." The sounds of Christmas carols fill the air and add warmth and joy to this already festive time of year.
Ding dong, merrily ding dong, ding. ding dong, merrily ding, merrily ding dong, merrily ding, merrily ding dong, ding dong, ding merrily ding dong, merrily ding dong, ding dong, ding dong, merrily ding, merrily ding dong, merrily ding dong, merrily ding dong, ding ding dong, ding merrily ding dong, merrily ding dong.
Thank you.
in those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. And all went to be registered, each to his own town. And Joseph went out of Galilee, from the town of Nazareth in Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with his wife, Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. Shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flocks by night.
We can hear the tune you play.
hearts shone round about them, and they were filled with great fear. But the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you tidings of great joy. For unto you is born this day in the city of David the Savior, which is Christ the Lord." Swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angels a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace to all on the earth." And when the angels had gone away, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see."
The angels said, "Bye-bye."
angels came with haste and found Mary, Joseph, and the babe lying in the manger.
Thank you.
star that the wise men had seen rose before them until it came to rest over the place where the child was. And when they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they saw the child, they fell down and worshipped him and opened their treasures, offering him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Thank you.
prophecy. King of kings and Lord of lords, alleluia. These words from the work Messiah proclaim what this birth is about. Let us celebrate this season with the singing of Handel's most famous chorus. All alumni from the concert choirs of Minnewaska, Glenwood, Starbuck, and Villard are invited to join the 21-22 Minnewaska Concert Choir in singing the Hallelujah Chorus. But is the spirit and joy of this season only present during December? What happens after the presents are opened? The special meals are eaten after the decorations come down and the company leaves. Does the meaning of Christmas get packed away until next December? President Calvin Coolidge said, "Christmas is not a time or a season, but a state of mind. To cherish peace and goodwill, to be plenteous in mercy all the year around. That's what the real spirit of Christmas is." In a lowly stable, on a night when the world was very busy, a small child was born, unnoticed by almost everyone, except the lowly shepherds who were told by heavenly beings. This birth, so humble in its circumstance, has since become one of the greatest events celebrated around the world. It's the fulfillment of a promise that was given when the world was made, all on a silent, holy night. So may the spirit and joy of the Christmas season stay with you, not only today, but throughout the entire year. And may the gift that was given to us in a lowly manger bring you hope, comfort, joy, and especially peace forevermore.